or have it is a photo of my Nana. This is one of the prettiest photos of her I have. That's Nana Fatem, we call her Nana Fatem. I recently found out in March of this year, to be exact, one of my sisters in the Middle East traced the story of Nana. We know my dad's story, he's a very well-known family, and then we can trace them up to like until like 1700s. But my Nana's story was like history. So we recently found out that she was a six-month-old baby who survived the genocide, being carried by her brother and sister, four-year-old and a seven-year-old or some age, some other age. They carried the little girl into somehow through the desert of Syria or Iraq and northern Iraq, and then she made it. Long story, and then she was married and then moved to Baghdad, and here we are. She, the irony of the whole thing is during the Armenian genocide, the Ottoman Empire army that carried most of the genocide, the other part was carried on the Arabs and Kurds. I'm not going to go into the historical, but just a quick. My great-grandfather, from my dad's side, was a general in the army. So see how the fate twists and turns around. Like my Nana's survivor of the genocide, her daughter ends up marrying a son, a grandson of a general from the army. So if you ever have, ever doubt peace is possible, just think of this story. No matter how much tragedy happened, there's always a way out. There's always peace. Peace always comes. I'll start my book by reading a poem to get back to the being a speaker. So the last poem in my first book, my second book. Thanks a lot, Candace and Ken and Kathy and Sandra both for my book. I appreciate it. So the last poem called The Speaker. If witnessing humankind's cruelty renders you speechless, if insensitive words spoken both those you love hurt like a dagger in your chest, if you're awake after realizing you were on a path of self-destruction, yet those who know you do not expect you to change because you are shackled and in an immobile state of being with your head bound down by your all needless earthly possessions, wait for the right moment to speak out. The day will come when you find yourself in a spot where all eyes are on you and you can hear a pin drop. They listen to you speak. Grab this microphone and confidently speak. Speak up for those who have been forcefully silenced, unlawfully imprisoned, chained and legally gagged so they do not speak of what they know. Speak up for those who vanished without a trace and those who are labeled traitors for exposing crimes by those in power where innocent people perish. Speak up for those engraved words on prison walls and painted metal doors for you to read long after they were unjustly taken away. Speak up for those who gave up their lives dreaming to be in your spot right now to speak the truth. Speak up for those who are spending nights and nights unable to sleep because the secrets they know will expose men in power and could get them killed. Speak up for those who are not aware they are slaves because their spirits have been beaten down and crushed since childhood. They do not know even how to be free. Remind people of the bloody history those in power want you to forget. So for the sake of future generations, speak up for this hurting planet that is being suffocated, poisoned, polluted, and used and abused by those who worship nothing but wealth. Find your voice in the midst of clamor. Refuse to put price tag on your silence and be the speaker because this is your time to be the speaker.